Well, here we go, folks. Prepare for summer storms. Or recover from last year's storms, maybe more important. With the help of Campo Roofing, we're going to welcome Vice President Rick Campopiano. Love that name, man. It's like a song.
Thank you.
Yeah. Hey, so we're talking about, we know storms are coming, we might have roof problems, but the most important thing I took from that was that we have something we should be doing because of last year, and we have to do it now before the year turns into another year.
Yeah, I mean, you know, good ways to get your home prepped for this season is, you know, get your gutters clean. You know, make sure there's nothing in the gutters. Make sure you check your attic. Make sure you check the upstairs, see if there are any leaks over the wintertime. You know, and then do a visual inspection about around the whole house. You know, missing shingles, missing siding, dented window wraps, you know, window screens that have been destroyed by hail that you might have not have noticed last year.
So. Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of stuff that could have happened. And I guess the important thing to know is that your insurance could cover some of this stuff, but if you wait until the damage was over a year old, you're not going to get any help.
Yeah. Last summer we had a bunch of big storms, and usually it's about it's 12 months from the date of loss where you can, you know, report a claim. You know, I would check with your insurance brokers, people you deal with, and what they'll do is, you know, kind of guide you on that. So.
Hey, so I look at this roofing here and flashing problems, that sort of thing. And when siding blows off or a problem with the siding, you also help them with that.
Yeah.
Fascia board and all that.
Yeah. We help with siding, roofing, gutters, windows, even. So
what is this sheeting right here we're taking a look at, bare sheeting?
Yeah, I mean, you know, when wind blows off shingles, you have bare sheeting, you have bare Sellotex when siding gets blown off, you have trees in the houses. Anytime you see the actual substrate, you know, you're not in good shape and you need it addressed.
And, you know, you talked about checking, looking for leaks and stuff. I mean, this is pretty obvious. You got a big problem here. Maybe the insurance company's going to help you out, so you got to call immediately.
Yep.
But when you find those little drizzly looking leaks in the attic where just starting to sneak in, that could turn into like a big problem in a hurry.
It can. You wanna address those as soon as possible. You give us a call, we'll come out. Our service technicians can address the problem, you know, sometimes fix it on site or at least come up with a game plan to fix it.
Okay, I see a lot of like asphalt style roofing, like in three tab and that kind of thing. When people re-roof, like you do re-roofing jobs, do the roof always have to come off, or can you roof over roofs, or are there different situations?
It depends on the house, but about 99% of the time, it's best it just comes off, because then you can put ice guard down, then you could, you know, get to the root cause of the problem, rather than just, you know, putting lipstick on it, you know?
Yeah, well, let's talk about ice guard a little bit. I mean, we're past the ice season, but ice guard, it's a newer thing. It's less, what, 15, 20 years maybe?
Yeah, I see. It was invented back in the late 70s, early 80s, and then it became into really, you know, widespread use back in 2001 when it was required.
So you run that over the eaves, and that way when the ice backs up in a gutter, it doesn't go underneath the roof. So to put a roof over a roof and you don't have the ice guard, it doesn't do any good.
Correct, yep.
Yeah,
so if you're having ice damming issues, you're going to have issues regardless, even if you put a new roof over the existing one.
So when you offer people like flashing, like the flashing on chimneys and valleys and all that kind of stuff, do you offer different things for different people, or is there just like one way Campo Roofing does it?
There's usually just one way to do it, but you know, there is special circumstances and special things that a customer might have unique needs for it.
Yeah.
You know, we can assess every project differently, but usually there's only really one real good way to do it.
But you have this pesky problem forever at your house, and you want to stay in your house, and you want your house to be beautiful, and you can count on it. You got to have the right kind of roof on it, and you guys do it.
Correct. Yeah, it all starts from the top.
Yeah. Hey, how about that? We talked about that ice guard stuff. How about you put a metal edge on the fascia too sometimes?
Yeah. We put a drip edge there. It's required by code. It's pretty common on pretty much all houses now. Right. And, you know, that's just another barrier of protection that can help keep your house
dry. How about permits? Yeah, people have to take out permits to do re-roofing?
Yeah, permits, all that stuff. That whole process is handled by us. We work with all the cities and, you know, schedule the inspections, because a lot of cities now require inspections too. So.
Yeah, and if you see something that could be covered by insurance, you can alert them, because you'll recognize it and you can tell the homeowner how to do that.
Yeah, I just try to guide them and tell them, you know, this is, you know, what homeowners usually do in this situation, and this is what, in my experience, is probably the best course of action.
Financing?
Financing, we do offer financing. Just really depends on the situation, if it makes sense. But a lot of times, you know, if you have an unexpected roof need, financing is the only way to get it done, so.
Natalie, do you think we have this covered?
I think you do. And if you don't, they can always go to camporoof.com and learn more and talk with Ricky and the team,
How
right?
Good is she, huh?
She's great.